Hello guys, how are you all? Good morning. This is Prashant. I welcome you all. And today's topic, as you can see on the screen, Python is strings. So today we are going to discuss about the Python is strings. I think we all are familiar with the strings. When we are writing something between these two quotes, this is known as a string. Okay, these two quotes, if we are going to write down anything between these two quotes, it considered as a string. So what is exactly a string? A string is a Python in a sequence of characters. It is a derived data type. The string is are immutable. This means that once defined, they cannot be changed. Immutable, I think it is already clear to you what is immutable. We cannot change. But a string is a sequence of our characters. Okay, so when we are going to write down the some characters, as S is a character, T is a character, R is a character, I, N, G, so these are the small characters. When we are going to arrange them all together, it considered as a string. So I think a string, basic definition of a string is clear to you. So now, what are the strings? Literals. So here the string literals, how we can define the different types of string in Python. So here you can see that hello you can write down between two quotes, and this is similar to this, means that these both are equal. You can write down in the single quotes and you can write down in the double quotes also. Okay, so these are the examples to use in the Python. Okay, so if you will run this code, it will show you the similar output. Okay, now how you will assign, if you are going to assign a variable to accept the string, so you can assign as a equals to hello, then print a, so it will give you the hello output. Okay, it will give you the hello. Okay, so my dear, I think it is clear to you. So next, here you can see some other types of a string, means when you want to write down something in the multiple lines, so you can give triple quotes, 1, 2, and 3. These are the triple quotes and ending with the same triple quotes. So these are the multiple lines of a string. So these are the multiple lines. Here I accept a as a variable. A is accepting this, handling this line, and this print a is printing this line. So as the similar, you can see the double quotes and the single quotes. Similarly, you can do here. These are the double quotes and these are the single quotes. So all the things are similar. So these are the things that you have to remember. So now next we have the string as array. Before go to the next topic, we must understand the string index value. A string is a array. Arrays, what do you mean by arrays? Actually, it is a topic of C or C++ language. Actually, you are the Python students or class 11 CS students are not having the array completely in their topic. So that's why I'm defining this here. Array is a sequence of a variable. So when you are keeping the anything, either it is a string or a number or something else, it should be in a sequence. Means the index value 0, 1, 2. It should have a sequence of a values, so it considered as a array. So that's why it is saying strings are arrays. So yeah, it is arrays. So how will you define this one? So let's see here. Here we are accepting a variable Python string. It is written Python string. So when you are going to define Python string in a table, it will accept the value as 0, 1, 2. It will open a table with the sequence where your values p occupied the place 0, y occupied the index value for 1, this t will occupy for 2, and h will occupy for 3, and so on. Here, one thing you have to remember, as you can see, space is here. So space is also a character. So it will accept the space, means it will accept the index value. Make it sure that you have to remember this thing. Okay? So now, here one thing is there. So if I am going to write down print a of 2, that means index value I am writing. So I will get a of 2. So index value a of 2 is t. So I will get the t here. As you can go this forward direction, similar you can come at the backward direction. But make it sure when you are going from the forward direction, it will start from 0 to minus 1, length minus 1, whatever is the length, it will be the minus 1. But when you are coming from backward, it will start from minus 1 to up to the length. So make it sure, if you are going to write down 2, means if you are going to write down print A of 2, so it will print T. If you are going to write down A of minus 11, so it will also print T. So make it sure the address you can write down in the both the direction, forward direction or the backward direction. Next topic, how you will do the slicing of a string. So slicing is also an important thing, that if I want to write down this many key, this only this words, this words I read PYT. So how will I write down this PYT? So this is called the slicing, means you are going to make a chop 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 everywhere. This means I need this much and I need this much. So you are making the small small chops for this. So how will you do this? So we have a string slice. We have a string slice here. We have a string slice here. So how will I do this? Here you can see we are accepting a string. We are printing a string. Here is a method 0 to 5. Okay. 0 is the index value first, and 5, it is 4. Minus means L minus 1, the length minus 1. It will print 0, 1, 2, 3. So means PYTH. It will print PYTH. 0 to 4, sorry, I counted by 3. I have to count till 4. I have to count till here. So how will I do this? 0, 1, 2, 3, PYTHO. So Pytho, it will print. It will print Pytho. So I think it is clear to you. So you can make a slicing from the beginning. You can make a slicing from the middle. You can slicing from the end point also. You can slicing from the backside also. So it is your opinion that how you want to do this. So here the output is, you can see, print 6 to 11. So 6 to 11 means it will 6 to 11. It will accept 6 to 10. So what it will print? It will print space STRI. STRI. So I think it is pretty clear to you. So next topic. Now, examples for Python slices. So here is the example. I accept a Python string. If you are going to use this, it will print this. If you are going to use this, it will print this. So here you can see one thing I must clear here. If you are going to write down like this, so it will print exact string, means it will print the copy of original. Okay, because starting point and the ending point is not given here. So here you will give the starting point, here you will give the ending point. If you are not giving anything, as suppose you are giving this value, this colon and 5, so what will happen? It will accept the value from 0. Okay, by default it will accept the value from 0 if you are not going to give any value. If you are using like this 2, it is 2, it looks like a 1, 2 and ending point, you are not going to give the ending point. So if you will give 2 to 0 2 to empty place, so it will start from 2 and it will reach up to the last point, because you have not given the last point. So I think it is clear. So here are the some examples of the same thing that you can do. As you can see here, if you are not having this much value, 1 to 100, so YTHO, so YTHON, it is counting from here 0, 1, 2, 3 and THON. So we don't have up to 100, so it will accept from first value to last value. It will not go next. Okay, so it is too big truncated. Now, we have some examples more. You can do yourself. It is a backward string. Here you can see it is a backward string. Okay, so now we are going to do some exercise. So it is exercise for you. You please pause the video and find out the answer of these questions. Okay, and write down in the comment section. You can search it is A and it is B, it is C and it is D. So there are the four parts that you can write down in the comment section. Okay, so now here we have some functions. Actually, string having some functions to help you out to make your work easier. So here is the first function is length. So how will you do this? How will you use it? As suppose your variable A is handling this string hello world, and you want to calculate what is the length of this. So no need to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. You have to write down only length of A, length of string function and the variable name, you will get the output here. Okay, so length will help you to find out the length of a string. Now a string function is strip. So strip, what will happen, what will be the use of strip? Strip will help you to remove the white space from front and at the back. If you are giving, you can see here, it is a space here. Okay, it is a space here. So if you want to remove this space, then you have to use strip function. It will help you to remove the space from front and the rear position. Make it sure, my dear student, that you have to use it, yet you have to remember it. Okay, you have to remember it. It will help you to solve many questions. And the method to use it, you can see length is different thing and strip is different. In length, we are writing the variable name inside. Okay, variable name inside. Here the a dot strip, a is calling the strip. It is clear to you? So make it sure that you have to learn this one. Next one, we have lowercase, uppercase. The similar way, if you can see here, these alphabets are in lower uppercase. If you want to make it lower, then you have to use a dot lower. So it will convert the h and w. You can see h and w converts into the small case, means lower case. Okay, so here is the main thing. Now uppercase is the just opposite of that. Here you can see e l l o O R L D means hello world. The rest of the alphabets are in a small. So by the using of uppercase, you can see the all the cases are converted into the uppercase. Okay, the method of using is a dot upper. Now we have replace. Replace, you can make a changes in alphabets if you want to write down. As you can see, you if you are writing a dot replace, and which alphabet you want to change by which one. Okay, as suppose H I want to replace by the J. So here you can see hello becomes jello. Okay, so it is clear to you. Make it sure, students, that after, as I am explaining the things, so you have to do the practice yourself, because practice is needed, practice is important. Okay, if you will not do the practice, you can't remember these functions. You have to do the practice. Practice is a key of success in programming language, because when we are doing the programming, at the certain time we have to call the functions from the our memory. So how we will call it? So like this, if you will do the practice, you can call them. Okay, so next function we can see here, split. How will you use the split? Split, you want to break this string into part, two parts. This is one part, this is another part. So make it sure, when you want to break it, you have to find out the break point. Okay, you have to find out the break point. As if I am giving this comma and split from comma, you can see hello is different quotes and world is in different quotes. That's why I make two colors in this, hello and world. It is it will come in the same color, huh? But for your explanation, I converted it into the two colors. So here is the thing that you have to remember, hello world, we are going to split from the comma. And make it sure, students, that you can use any word. As suppose you have used a hash, okay, hash word, or you want to break it from the O. So where from beginning, wherever it will get the first O, it will break from that portion only. Okay, so you can note, it will split the comma from the comma, because I gave a comma here. I gave a comma here, that's why it's breaking from the comma. Okay, so now next thing, we have in or not in. These are the small keywords. Okay, these are the small keywords, but having a good means we have to use them so many times. So you if you, it will be better for you that if you understand the use of these things here only. So here you can see the rain is Spain, stay mainly in the plain. I am finding x equals to this word in a, means a I n in a. So a is a variable. I am finding n in this variable, and this variable contain the this text. So find out a I n. It got the a I n. So it when as soon as it will get the in, it will print this condition is true. This will provide you the boolean operator. These true and false are the boolean operators. It will not give you anything else. It will give you the boolean operators. Okay. Now here you can see not in. N is there. So what it will do? It is finding not in. So we are finding this. This is in the string. So it will give the true, but we are kind of saying not in. So it will show you the false. So make it sure these both are the boolean operators, and in or not in is the just doing opposite work. So here we have the concatenation, means how to combine the two strings. So here we have the examples of the concatenation, means when you want to combine two strings. So here first string is hello, and B string and B variable handling the world. If C is equals to A plus B and I am going to print the C, it will print hello world. But make it sure there is no space between these two words. If you want to make the space, so you will use like this and you will get a space. Okay. So before you have to use it, you please check the operator. Here is the concatenation operator plus. Sorry, I forget to tell you. This is the concatenation operator plus we have to use here. So here is the plus, you can see. Okay. Now the next. Here some more functions are here which you can use as is alpha num. Make it sure, my dear students, this is alpha num is asking the question from you, the thing which you have given to check is alphabet or numeric. Okay, is alphabet or numeric. So if you are going to use a text variable handling this company 12, so you can see here is alpha num, it contain the alphabet as well as the numbers. So as I am going to print out this, it will print true, the boolean operator. Is alpha num will print the boolean operator. It contains the string and means alphabets and the numbers also. Okay, here are the some things. Some is num, is alpha num, is decimal, is digit, is lower, is numeric, is in space, is upper. For you have to use them and you are asking the questions. So make it sure, I'm clearing this, that here you are asking the question that whatever the string I am giving is alpha num. If it is alpha num, then it is true. If it is not alpha num, it is false. Okay, that you have to remember. So here are some functions for you that you have to use it, do the program, make the program on this and check your alphabets for yourself. Okay, so I hope you will do this work and thank you. Have a nice day. We will meet in the next lesson. Bye.